First off, I want to thank the brave men and women who work behind the wall. I want to thank them on a national level because their job goes unrecognized.
How did they try to turn a guard?
Well, correctional officer. Sorry, I apologize. But correctional officer.
How you guys doing today? It's Anthony Gangi, host of Tier Talk. Got a great video coming your way. My boy Michael Pataro was able to give us that video on mandated overtime. Basically, it's working more with less. That may be a great business model for a lot of places, but doesn't work in corrections. And he talks about how it adds to the mental health and well-being of our officers. So after our sponsors, we're going to check out Michael Pataro's video on mandated overtime and the negative consequences it can have on staff and the facility. Now that show Tier Talks for you, you brave men and women at work in corrections. So please, if you haven't, subscribe, interact, engage, comment, hit that bell. That bell will notify you every time I post up a video. I stand by for our sponsors.
I wanted to attend a university that had an intelligence program. I wanted to look at problems different. I wanted to increase my critical thinking abilities. AMU offered those avenues to expand. Obtaining your degree as an adult, you're actually paying yourself and investing in yourself. You can't put a dollar on it, it's priceless. It's something that can never be taken away from you.
American Military University. Learn from the leader.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is Dr. Michael Pataro from American Military University. I want to thank Anthony for reaching out to me, for giving me a little shout out about my most recent article focusing on mandatory overtime and the physical and financial consequences associated with overtime. What's not mentioned in the title, but is in the article itself, talks about how this can take an emotional toll on us, physically, emotionally, and then how it can bleed over into our personal relationships and affect them as well. Plus, of course, as you know, there's also a safety factor that's involved there. In the article, I stated that, you know, when you go X amount of hours without any sleep, it starts to have the same effects as if you were drinking and driving. So that's a concern, that are you actually able to perform your job to the best capacity? And that's a problem that we have to really consider. So whenever I decide to write something, I focus more on the issues that I think that need attention, and I'm very fortunate to have worked my way up to this position where I can basically bring attention and awareness to these topics. And this is one that I know a lot of my friends who are still in the field have expressed some concerns over, that they seem to be putting in more hours with less staff, you know, supervision to help them out. So there seems to be a shortage. So this is a kind of like a twofold area. We have you working the mandatory overtime, and then we have lack of available officers to fill in those spots so you don't have to work so much overtime. So this is a danger to me because it puts you at risk, because the longer that you're sleep deprived, the more it's going to cause some cognitive impairment and it's going to cause some health concerns. So this has a huge, huge ripple effect on people. So that's why I'm trying to bring attention to this, you know, and of course, you know, the financial consequences to me, I wanted to take a different angle, is that let's say that there's a situation that, you know, involves excessive force, because I don't know about you guys, but when I don't eat or don't sleep enough, I kind of get a little, you know, hangry and a little nasty, short tempered. So that would come out in my personality. So for me personally, being sleep deprived, it does affect my personality. So this is a situation where you may not be completely rational in your judgment. You may not be rational in your behaviors and your actions. So there's a fear that you can do something that you normally would not do if you had, you know, worked a normal shift. So if you're looking at 16 hours plus, then that's going to affect you, and that's going to affect how you treat others, okay? And I think it puts you at a little bit of a risk there with the prisoners as well, because you're kind of not at your full capacity. You're not 100% alert of your surroundings. And I think that's important to note. So unfortunately, this is an area, once again, that still needs attention. I never really understood the concept behind, you know, trying to do more with less. I understand that there's an issue there with, you know, trying to obtain and retain officers and staff members. I get that. But the other part of it is, you know, we seem to be concerned about, you know, money for paying for the salaries and the benefits. Yet in the long run, if something bad happens, something goes south, as I always say, then there's going to be repercussions in that sense with a lawsuit, which will cost far more than any officer's salary. So to me, it would be better to err on the side of caution by hiring more officers, more so than trying to work the ones you do, work them to death, essentially. And I think that, you know, it also leads to burnout, stress, and then people looking for other positions or getting out of the field entirely. So you may have some good workers, and I'm sure, you know, most of you consider yourself to be exceptional workers, and you may, you know, decide that you want to switch careers or move on to something else just because of this. So this is one area that, to me, is fixable. It can be fixed. So I think that we need more attention drawn to it. So one of my friends actually commented on the article and talked about guilt shaming is another one. So I think I'm going to take that on. In other words, you know, kind of like, it's not mandatory per se, but, you know, we really need you to work. You're going to leave us short, you know, kind of that guilt that you feel, so that if you, you know, decline, then you're leaving everybody kind of exposed. And then if something goes wrong, you're going to carry that guilt with you. So that's another area of concern that definitely needs to be addressed. In closing, though, I'm always looking for different ideas to write about. So if you have anything, please reach out to me or reach out to Anthony so I can kind of tackle those issues and bring some attention to them. So it's not just, you know, with my own publications. Obviously, Anthony's been very gracious enough to promote my articles and promote my work on his site, but then also Corrections One. And I also have been now have a contract with Psychology Today. So if you have any ideas or suggestions for future articles, please reach out to me. I'd love to hear from you. And, you know, I want to make sure that I have your back and that I'm trying to, you know, work for you guys from the outside, trying to help as much as possible from what I can do. And so for me, it's just bringing awareness to these issues so that, you know, we can bring more attention and hopefully get them rectified. Okay. Thank you and have an awesome day. Oh!